Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. Today we're going to do another beginner friendly project. It's been like what, 7 months since I did my last Arduino related content? So yeah, we're going to use some 10k potentiometers and an optional 16x2 LCD with I2C backpack in conjunction with the FastLED liquid crystal library and the analog input and analog in out serial sample code from the Arduino IDE to control the brightness level and color values of a WS2812B addressable RGB LED chip. Doing that would enable us to mix colors to our desired hue or intensity and use it however we like. We can use it on multiple things such as ambient or mood lighting, bias lighting behind monitors, or just the normal LED lights inside our computer cases. Granted that there are multiple LED controllers and softwares that you can even use via Wi-Fi or Bluetooth connection and generally works a lot better than this, you can't deny the fact that by just using a few potentiometers and LED strips, you can build one or make one for yourself as well, just without the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. But since this is designed to be modular, you can add and remove features or functions like that as you like anyway. Do keep in mind that I would only be using a single LED chip here for demonstration. You can use more than one LED chip if you want. Also, just like on all of my previous Arduino projects, all the necessary links, including the sources, codes, schematics, and other good stuff would be available in the description down below. Let's go! Here are the things that we need. First up is a breadboard. An Arduino Nano that would be the brain of operations. You can use other MCUs if you want. I just chose this because it's small and has just the right amount of analog pins for what I want to do.
Totally not because it's the first thing that I saw when I was still planning on what to use.
A few 10k potentiometers, 4 pieces to be exact. These would control the brightness level and color values of the red, green, and blue LEDs on the WS2812B chip. An optional 16x2 LCD with I2C backpack to display the values more neatly. I borrowed this from my sub counter, by the way. Click right here to check it out. Some hookup wires to hook up everything together. The WS2812B RGB LED chip that we will use to test our code. You may have seen this one already from a previous video where I used it as a test LED. Click right here to check it out. And of course, the data cable. Can't do anything without it. Now that we've got our things ready, first thing we need to do is test the potentiometers to see if they are working correctly. For this test, we're going to need the breadboard, the Arduino Nano, and some hookup wires. Again, all the necessary links including the sources, codes, schematics, and other good stuff would be available in the description down below. Okay, let's attach the Arduino to the breadboard, followed by the 10k potentiometer. Attach it like this. For this circuit, it doesn't matter if we connect the 5 volts or ground supply to the first or last pin of the potentiometer, since it would only affect how the values would be displayed on the serial monitor. For example, if we attach the ground to the last pin, the zero value would start from the right side and would increase as you turn the knob to the left and vice versa. And then, the second or middle pin is for the signal. Now let's get some hookup wires, connect the red and black colored ones to the 5 volts and ground of the Arduino Nano, and then connect the other leg to the 5 volts and ground supply rail of the breadboard. Connect the first pin of the potentiometer to the 5 volts rail and the third pin to ground. After that, connect the second or middle pin of the potentiometer to A0 of the Arduino Nano using a jumper cable. I've changed the jumper wire and cable here, by the way, because it's producing erratic results. Alright, let's plug it in and upload the code. By the way, this is basically just an edited version of the analog input sample code from the Arduino IDE. So, POT is the potentiometer which is connected to analog pin 0. POTVAL is the potentiometer value which was added to store the values that are being read from analog pin 0. The analog read command converts the input voltage of 0 to 5 volts to digital values between 0 and 1023. This is handled by the analog to digital converter circuit inside the MCU. Serial begin is just for us to use the serial monitor, and serial print line is for us to see what the analog pin reads from the potentiometer or the potentiometer value. Now, let's try if the potentiometers are working correctly. And since I have the ground connection on the last pin, I would have to turn the knob to the left in order to increase the value. It should start from 0 and go up to 1023. Turning the potentiometer all the way to either direction, left or right, changes the resistances between the center pin and the two outside pins and gives a different voltage at the analog pin. For example, when the knob is turned all the way to the left and your 5-volt supply is connected to the first pin of the potentiometer, which is on the left side, there would be zero resistance between the center or second pin and the 5-volt supply, which would then turn the voltage at the center pin to 5 volts. 5 volts would then be converted by the analog read command and change the analog value to digital, which would make it 1023, and would make it 0 if the knob is turned all the way to the right because that is where the ground connection is. However, if the potentiometer's knob is at the middle position, analog read returns a number between 0 and 1023 that is proportional to the amount of voltage being applied to the pin. And that's it for the potentiometer tests. Let's get the WS2812B LED chip and add it to the circuit to test the code for the brightness control. Let's connect this red one to 5 volts, the black one to ground, and the last one to digital pin number 2. Plug in the Arduino, then click on upload. For this one, I have added the FastLED library and some FastLED commands to control the LED chip. NumLEDs is the number of LED chips that are connected. In this case, we only have one. Data pin is where the data in of the LED chip is connected. We have ours connected to digital pin number 2. CRGB is the representation of an RGB pixel. LEDs is the block of memory that will be used for storing and manipulating LED data of the connected LEDs. I have also added the analog in-out serial sample code from the Arduino IDE to convert the digital value from analog read using the map function. OutVal represents the remapping of the potentiometer values or POTVal from 0 to 1023 and 0 to 255. On the void setup, serial begin just like on the test code was added to start serial communication and to enable us to use the serial monitor. AddLEDs tells the library that there's a strand or in this case a single WS2812B chip that is connected to digital pin number 2. Not really sure, but GRB is just for color arrangement of the LEDs, I think. The LEDs connected to digital pin 2 will use the block of code or LED array called LEDs and will control the number of LEDs specified on NumLEDs. On the void loop, just like on the potentiometer test code, POTVAL is the value that is being read by analog read from POT, which is analog pin 0. Serial print line to see what the OutVAL value is, and the analog write would write the values to
Okay! After some reading, I found out that the analog write should have the data pin and not NumLEDs here. But, weirdly enough, it still worked.
Interesting. So, according to Arduino references, analog write would write the values to the pin where it's connected to, and to the value or OutVAL. Set brightness is a FastLED command that, sets the brightness. Usually, the set brightness command is a fixed value. But, since we need to change it, we added the OutVal instead. The set brightness command also ranges from 0 to 255 as well, so we have to do it. Again, LEDs is the block of memory that will be used for storing and manipulating LED data of the connected LEDs, which in this case is the array of 0 or 1 LED chip since it's using the decimal number system and because we only have one chip connected. CRGB is the representation of an RGB pixel which has the value of 255, 255, 255 or white. Each value constitutes a color on the RGB pixel, i.e. red, green, and blue. When the red, green, and blue colors are at max value, they produce the color white. We can also make it LEDs 0 equals CRGB double colon white to make it shorter. But we need to use the three values later, so we don't need to change it this time. And finally, fastled.show. Fastled.show basically just tells the library to show the data. Alright, let's try it out. Just gonna turn off the lights. If I adjust the knob to the left, which is where the 5-volt supply is connected, the RGB LED chip starts to light up. That's just on brightness level number 2. And as I further twist it anti-clockwise, the brightness increases. The brightness increases or decreases in conjunction with the value that is being read by the analog read. Looking back at what we have discussed during the potentiometer test, when the knob is turned all the way to the left and your 5-volt supply is connected to the first pin of the potentiometer which is on the left side, there would be zero resistance between the center or second pin and the 5-volt supply, which would then turn the voltage at the center pin to 5 volts. The same thing happens if we turn the potentiometer to the right where the ground supply is connected, but instead of 5 volts or 255 value, we get 0. And that's it for the brightness test. So we've just finished testing the potentiometers and brightness control code. Let's move on to the final stage of this project. Brightness control and color mixing. To do that, we have to disconnect everything except this one potentiometer right here, because this is where we would attach the other three. Let's attach the potentiometers like this. And then, it would also be better if we connect the hookup wires at the back, since we can see the potentiometer pins clearly that way. Now that we're done with this part, let's get another breadboard to attach the Arduino. Connect the power supply rail of the breadboard to the 5 volts and ground supply of the Arduino. And then, connect the first potentiometer to analog pin 0 of the Arduino, second potentiometer to analog pin 1, and so on. Now, let's connect the Arduino to the computer for us to test the code first before attaching the LED, just to see if our connections are good and if we're getting the correct values. Upload the code, and there we go. The code works exactly just like the brightness control code earlier. As you can see here, I only copy-pasted it, added, and changed some variables. Bright pot is the first potentiometer that controls the brightness. Red pot is the second potentiometer that controls the values of the red LED on the WS2812B chip. Green pot is the third potentiometer that controls the values of the green LED, and blue pot is the fourth potentiometer that controls the values of the blue LED. The main difference is that I have added a few if statements that would make the serial monitor only display the values that are greater than or equal to 10. Without it, the serial monitor would be flooded with values from the four potentiometers and would be hard to test them one by one because we can see the values clearly. Also, on the LEDs array, instead of a fixed value, I have added the remapped values of the LEDs, red out val, green out val, and blue out val, so that the hue of each LED changes in conjunction with the values from analog right. Doing that would let us change the colors of the LED. For example, if we change the value of red and blue LED to 255 and keep green on 0, it would show up or display this color. The color changes depending on its value. I only used IQ here for demonstration. It works the same with LEDs. Alright, let's see. First, let's test the potentiometer that would control the brightness. Nothing is displayed on the serial monitor until it's not getting a value greater than or equal to 10. Now, let's actually test it with an RGB LED connected. Just like before, connect it to 5 volts, ground, and digital pin 2. As I turn the potentiometer to the left and increase the value, the LED is not lighting up. That's because it doesn't matter if the brightness setting is high if the color values are at 0. Remember, we're controlling the values of the brightness and color separately. Just gonna turn off the lights again to see it better. Let's increase the brightness value to, let's say, 20-ish. Now let's increase the value of color red. As you may have noticed, even if the color value is maxed at 255, it doesn't get any brighter because the brightness level is just 20-ish. But if we increase the brightness, the red color becomes brighter. Let's change the values of both red and brightness to max or 255 and increase the value of the green LED. See? It becomes yellow. And if we adjust the value of the red color to 0, it only displays green. Now, let's add some blue into the mix. It becomes blue-green, cyan, or I don't know what color that is. So, we can set it to a lot of different colors just by changing the values. But, if we adjust all the potentiometers to 255, it becomes white. That's basically it, really. As simple as that. But of course, we can add an LCD to the circuit to see the values more clearly. I mean, using the serial monitor is okay, but the values just keep on scrolling like live chats on livestream videos. Here's the 16x2 LCD with an I2C backpack that I'm going to use. Connect the 5 volts and ground to the Arduino, then SDA or serial data pin to analog pin 4 and SEL or serial clock pin to analog pin 5. Let's hook it up, and then upload the code. The code is just like the color mixing code that we have used earlier, but instead of using the serial monitor, we will be using the LCD, which in my opinion is better. I have also removed the if statements here. Let's increase the brightness level to 255. It's a bit jumpy though, not sure why. I've read somewhere that adding a capacitor would help a bit, but
this is fine.
Moving on to red, green, and of course, blue. The only problem with this setup is the spacing, because the values of blue is being cut off when both the red and green values are maxed out. Let me just turn off the lights for the final demo, and there we go. Just a reminder, all the necessary links, including the sources, codes, schematics, and other good stuff would be available on the description down below. Thanks for watching, and see you again next week. Maybe.